So, welcome to Studio 39's gallery space. My name is Brian Chat. I am the lead vocal music teacher on the PVA High School side of things. With me, I have Alyssa Cox, one of our lovely guest artists and teachers for the program, and then Laura Mueller, who's a teacher, accompanist, coach, everything that you could kind of bundle all in one. So we'd like to welcome you to our space. For you tonight, we have an excellent program planned. A variety of love songs, and some are happy love songs, some are sad, some are angry, from a variety of styles, from musical theater, and then we'll be ending with some German art songs. So there's a good mix that you can kind of cling to. During the performances, in between, as students are coming and going, feel free to excuse yourselves and enjoy beverages, coffee, tea, lemonade, cookies. You can eat in this space, we just ask that you're not moving about during a performance, that you wait for the conclusion and beginning to kind of move about the space. Feel free, if you want to document your students' performance via video, picture, feel free to do that. I just ask that the flashes off, just because that can be distracting to both our accompanists and our performers. I've introduced us. Tonight, one thing that we ask the students to do, because this is a Valentine's Day recital centering around love, we asked all of the students, hopefully they remember, that when they come up and they introduce themselves and the pieces they'll be performing, we ask them to reflect on what love means to them. And we ask that as part of their introduction, they just complete the statement, love is blank. So we decided to join in on the fun. So we thought to kind of kick things off, we would share our words. So I finished by saying, love is support.
Love is laughter.
Love is inclusion.
So we hope you enjoy the show. Feel free after our last performer, don't run. We're going to have a little talk back portion if you want to stick around and kind of talk to your students about their preparation for this, what they've learned, what they're working on, what's next. We're going to have a little talk back, so feel free to stick around for that at the end.
We may or may not have a surprise that is not listed on the program after our last performer as well. Oh, stick around.
So we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Julius Warfel. I am a ninth grader. I'll be singing A Lot of Living to Do from the production Bye Bye Birdie. Love to me is what you make of it. The piece is basically about a guy, and it's like his night to be free, and he's talking about, like, he's like a ladies' man. He's like, oh, this is my time. He's kind of like an Elvis Presley. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
ninth grader at Broadneck, and I will be singing 4131 by Sullivan and Gilberts. My song is about Mabel, the character who is singing, and her sisters walking on this beach, and they come across this ex-pirate apprentice, and she starts flirting with him, but she doesn't want her sisters to know because they're too prim and proper for all of this. Love to me is jubilance.
Thank you. my name is Diamond Bryant, and love is unjudgmental to me. And today I'll be singing Sometimes I Feel Like a Mother's Child by Mother Tobin. And my song is about an enslaved child who dreams of one day reconnecting with her.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Lily Yin, and my song, The Dream by Michael William Bell, is about a woman who later in her life finds herself in her thoughts, basically about the life she always imagined she had and things that she thought would go her way. Oh, and love to me is acceptance.
Smile, and tender as she when she said, as I'm Bryony Davis. Love to me is unity and freedom. The song I will be singing tonight is Oche Sate di Piegarmi by Alessandro Scarlatti. The song is about someone who's desperately in love with another person, but those feelings aren't returned to them, and it sort of outlines how miserable they feel about it.
Thank you.
Kichwenyo translates to my dream and is about a person who would rather die than be with their significant other. And I believe love is passion.
Thank you. I will be singing Von Ewiger Liebe by Brahms, and this song is about a boy who questions his strength and his significant other's strength to be together through certain hardships. His significant other is, however, able to reassure him by reminding him how strong love actually is.
Thank you. Good evening. I'm Jack Williams, junior. I believe love is dedication, and I'll be singing for you "Zueignung" by Richard Strauss. It's about a man's dedication to God, his belief that God has done all the great things for us, and thanking God.
Thank you. Love is trust. I'll be singing Mid-Month by Robert Schumann, and my piece was actually a wedding gift for his wife, and it's about the dedication they put in their relationship for one another.
Thank you.
This concludes the performance part of our recital, but we wanted to take an opportunity, because as singers we normally don't do something like this, and just kind of open it up, and if anybody has any questions for the students in regards to how they prepared for this, what maybe they've learned, just anything. Yeah?
Jack Williams, were you at Brooklyn or somewhere in Glen Arden?
Oh, yeah.
No one has any?
Sure.
Yes, absolutely. I was just wondering, like, if they ever get to compete as a group, like, you know, we're freshmen, so in middle school you went to like Hershey Park or something like that, because they could actually win for
life. Yeah, so if you look at the upcoming events, we actually, this last piece that we performed as a choir, we're doing the whole PVA ensemble, which is about 45 to 50 students. We are performing and competing, if you will, in the County Choral Festival on March 16th. And then we are traveling to Longwood College in Virginia on the 17th to have a collaborative concert with the college students to work with some of their faculty.
Guys are mostly chorus, so I imagine doing solos was very out of the box and nerve-wracking. How many are glad it's over?
It's not.
Do you like singing rather in solo or chorus?
Chorus.
Well, I'm very proud of you because it took a lot of guts to get up there and sing insane without your game.
The nice part about the PVA vocal program is that it's kind of split evenly between this idea of ensemble performing as well as solo education. So these students have been working intensively this past semester and even now in training vocal technique, learning about vocal health, style, character, and how to bring that all into some of these very, very difficult pieces. A lot of these pieces in many cases are collegiate. These are some pieces that many of us studied when we were at college, and they've done a beautiful job preparing them, learning the various style that goes along with each composer, and making them their own in a very healthy way. So they've done a beautiful job as an ensemble, absolutely, but they've certainly made their own marks as soloists as well, I would say, for sure. So it's one of the wonderful things about this program is that they get to explore their own voices as well as collaborate as a team and make something really special together.
And you can grill them on their pieces too. They know everything about their pieces. We welcome those questions.
Well, if there's no further questions, that concludes our evening. Thank you for joining us. We hope to see you at the next one.